Hello, good days to all my fellow travelers, photographers, and friends around the world. Welcome to Chris Lee Travel Channel. Wish you all in good health. In today's episode, this is also the fifth episode of my travel journey to Guizhou province of China. I will share with you two of the most and must visit tourist spots in southeastern Guizhou. And both of them are traditional Miao village, right? And each with their own uniqueness and characteristics. The name of this Miao village are the Basha Miao Village, as you can see from this image, and also the Shiqiao Miao Village, as in this second image, right? And located in Chongjiang County and also the Danzhai County, respectively. Now, both counties are between the Qingdongnan, Miao and Dong autonomous prefectures, right, in Guizhou province. Now, the area that color in red in this map of China is the whereabouts of Guizhou province. And the provincial capital of Guizhou is Guiyang, located in the center of the province as shown in this map. Now, as mentioned in my earlier episodes, Guizhou is a mountainous province with high plateaus and dense network of rivers and valleys. In the early years, the tourism in this province was much restricted and affected by the topographies and inaccessibility of these regions. All these restrictions, right, and also obstructions are now the thing of the past. So in this Guizhou maps, right, the location of Qingdongnan, Miao and Dong autonomous prefectures, right, is being highlighted in yellow colors. Now, it is important to note that my Guizhou journey took place in the year 2011. Thus, all images in these travelogues are 10 years old. Now, as much emphasis has been placed by the China governments to uplift the living standards and well-being of their citizens, particularly in poorer provinces such as Guizhou over the last few decades. Now, viewers are reminded that the present condition of these villages and living standard of villages could be different, right, from my travel images. It's very unlikely to have no progress and or improvement in this village over the last 10 years, particularly when the rapid developments and modernization have swept across the entire China. Now, the only thing remain unchanged or unaffected is the cultures and traditions which the China government is taking every possible steps to preserve them. So the first Miao village in this episode is the Basha Miao Village or Basha Miao Zai in Chinese in the Chongjiang County. Basha Miao Village stood right on the hill about 550 meters above sea level in Chongjiang County, about 6 km south of Chongjiang City. Now, the village houses 505 households with approximately 2,600 inhabitants. Now, the location of the Chongjiang County is being highlighted in these maps. Now, this is the only village in China that allowed the villagers to own gun or firearm. Therefore, this village is well known to the world and in China as the last gunslinger in China, right? The inhabitants of this village been named the Gunmen tribe by many. Now, this village has been recognized as the cultural heritage village by the provincial government in the year 2009. Okay, this is the main entrance arch to the Basha village. This image and the next few images are the surrounding scenes around the village, viewed from a mid-hill not far from the entrance. Now, this village has a lot of unique cultures, traditions and customs. One of them is the use of guns to welcome guests. The other include the traditional manhood ceremony, also known as Bar Mitzvah, all right, in the Western world. Now, the worshipping of sun and three gods and the adopting tree as the godparents. Now, some of these traditions and practices still in existence till the present day. Now, it was learned that the deceased villagers will have no tombstone on their grave, but instead, the tree is planted on the grave. Okay, let's look at this tourist map of Basha village. It's a small village with only a few roads. We entered the village from the location marked entrance and then headed to the performance stage for the cultural show, then followed with a walk in the village along the sightseeing routes as shown in this map. So please take note of the three locations as shown in this map. Now, with the pre-arrangements, the village conduct a guest welcoming ceremony to welcome us. Now, in this welcoming ceremony, some of the male villagers were carrying guns with them, and their attires were all in hand-mixed reflective black color clothing. And the main attire of Basha male, both the skirt and trousers, are of color blacks, made of their homemade clothes. They always carry a knife at the waist level with them. And lastly, having a very unique hairstyle as exhibited in this image. Please look carefully. As for the young ladies, the attire are much colorful, with multi-layer clothing, base layers generally in black, with colorful embroideries on the outer layers. Now, generally short skirt up to the knee height. Now, the exposed lower limbs are usually wrapped with colorful cloths. These ladies are all keeping long hair. Villagers have a very unique customs. They believe trees are their parent gods or the godparents. As such, at young age, each child will adopt a tree as their godparents. Falling off trees are strictly prohibited in the village unless permission is obtained. Now, the villager will plant a tree whenever a newborn baby in the village. This is the god trees, three gods that Basha Miao tribe is worshipping, as seen in this image. This image shows the main touring routes in the village, a much quiet and peaceful village if compared with Xijiang Miao Village. These are some of the wooden dwellings found around the village. Interesting roof features at end and center of the roof ridge if you pay special attention to it. Now the external facade of one of the dwellings attract my attention. Now the window leaves are very beautifully constructed. This is the entrance art to one of the subsection of the village. It's quite common in Miao village that they divide into sub-villages. Now, for much older dwellings, their roofs are constructed of tree bark. This can be seen in this image and the following few images. This is some of the wall exhibits found in one of the restaurants where we had our meal, or rather our lunch there. So more street scenes, the close encounter with the villagers. Most women and young kids that we found while we were having a tour in this village. Interestingly, we found the hard labors are done by ladies. Note the clothing, black is the main color. So it's time for cover show. Now besides the guest welcoming ceremony upon our arrivals, we also witnessed their traditional cultural show performance involving dancing and singing. And the amazing haircut writer, which formed the essential part of the manhood ceremony, which I have mentioned during the beginning of this episode. You need to be there in person to able to appreciate and witness this beautiful cultural performance. Now here you realize actually this is actually what I'm referring to, the amazing haircut writer, right? Which formed the essential part of manhood ceremony. Now boy in the village, when they reach the age between 7 and 15, within this range, right? Their parents will then arrange to hold a manhood ceremony for their child. One of the essential parts of the ceremony is performing haircut using sickles, as what you can see in this image. And this is a notice put up in the public notice board by the local government. Apparently, the government discouraged any form of early marriage and early childbirths. Now, we move on to the second male village I would like to share with you today. The Sichao Miao Village. Now, Sichao Miao Village is a small traditional Miao village nested in a mountain valley in Danzai County, at the southern region of Guizhou province. Now, Sichao means stone bridge. So, Danzai County has 75% of its population are of Miao ethnic minority. Now, the location of the Danzai County is been highlighted in this map. Now, this Miao village got its popularity among tourists through the existence of ancient handmade paper factory found in this village. Now, which are still in operations. Which about 40 families or less still earning a living from the manufacturing and selling of handmade paper. Thus, this village been given a nickname, the Village of Ancient Paper Making. Do you spot the uniqueness of this village dwellings? Now, the villagers here like red paper couplets, or we call it the Tuinian in Chinese, very much. You can almost see red paper couplets everywhere. It's a quaint countryside village with interesting tradition and heritage. It can be seen and captured in few of my images. Now, I'm not sure the stuff that dry on the floor in this image. On the left, could this be the tree bark for use in the paper manufacturing? If any viewer know about this, please update us in the comment column below. One of the very common features of this village is that, besides seeing red couplets everywhere, you will see golden corn everywhere as well. Both inside the buildings as well as outside the buildings. Hang right below the cantilever roof if. I found this air dry seasoned meat, or commonly known as bacons or la rou in Chinese, seemed to be a popular local delicacy. This meat were found drying in open air inside villagers' courtyards. Then on the street, we found this man using an axe chopping a tree trunk. We then curiously asked him what he's making or carving. He directed our view to his shop nearby. You guess what he is making? Give a smart guess. Haha, a wooden traditional Chinese coffin. the China style. Don't underestimate this coffin. Even while it's empty, it can have a weight of maybe close to 200 to 300 kilograms. Now, while strolling on the village streets, I spot many elderly women at work. Hardly see any young men around. This lady is actually shedding and the tree bark in preparation to use for the paper manufacturing. I peep into this family home and saw them having their lunch. And they are kind enough to allow me to take picture of them. Now, the surrounding of this village is very scenic. It's located near to a river with a very new wind and rain bridge that's spanning across the river. I then spot two village women washing their clothes beside the river. And then finally, I would like to share with you a 1,000-year-old traditional paper making technique that using tree bark as its raw materials. Now, it is believed to have inherited from the Tang Dynasty. These handmade paper factories in this village are of the protected business by the local government. Now, this is a tank of slurry contains mixture of water and cellulose fibers obtained from tree bark. From tree bark to fiber have to undergo numerous processes such as chopping, shredding, grinding, and pulping before they can be used. Now, the screen, right, made of the fine mass, is then immersed into the slurry solution, then slowly, right, lifting, right, up to allow, right, these fibers to be evenly distributed, right, on top of the mass, and then the water will then drain off, leaving a thin and evenly distributed flat layer of fiber on the mass or screen, which then form the paper. This sheet of newly formed or wet paper, and then move from the screen, then to place and stack to form a stack of paper. They are then lightly pressed to get rid of the excess paper, as can be seen in this image. Then the paper are then removed from the stack and dried individually on large heated metal plates, as can be seen in this image. Behind the metal plates is they put some burning charcoal to heat up the surface of the metal plates. Right? They then place these papers on it. One is dry, again it was carefully removed, and then stack them, trim and pack for sale. So besides manufacturing paper, the villagers also use this handmade paper to make decorative colorful lanterns for sales to tourists. This is to improve the earning for the family. So this image and the next two images are my favorite images which I want to share with you, capture during the journey. So this is the end of the fifth episode of my journey to Guizhou, and hope you have been entertained. If you like my travel channel, please support by subscribing, share and like. A thumb up from you is very much important to me. I take this opportunity to thank you in advance for supporting this travel channel. And just a preview in the sixth episodes coming, in the coming week, I will bring you to a very beautiful and yet very traditional and unspoiled Dong village in Zhaoxing in Liping County. So please stay tuned. Now before I end, I would like to wish you all good health. Please stay safe, stay strong, and see you next week. And bye.